misconceptions about all the workforce that is not true. These days, there's a misconception that the younger workforce is better value proposition when it comes to hiring, training, or retention. There is no doubt that this tech-savvy younger workforce can meet the demands of customers in this highly volatile economical climate, but that shouldn't be stopping you from hiring or training the old ones. There are many advantages for having older workforce. They bring in a wealth of experience, flexibility, institutional memory, work ethic, loyalty, and reliability. If company wants to leverage older workforce, they must give up few stereotypical views about them on the first place. So let's look at some of the stereotypes floating around in the corporate boardrooms. Older workforce is less creative. Really? Well, younger workforce are likely to come up with a large number of ideas, fresh blood thinking, as they say. But practically, it's proven that these bunch of ideas, what they bring in big numbers, need not be always a workable solution. Also, some have already tried and failed. Others could be incoherent with company's culture and vision. Measuring the ultimate value of new ideas is more important than just measuring the number of ideas generated. Older workforce can think of adjacent ideas and projects because they know the functionality of an enterprise by experience. There's a value in that which cannot be ignored. Another myth is that older workers don't learn as well as younger workers. The misconception that you can't teach an old dog new tricks is good for dogs, but that analogy may not be entirely applicable to humans. Older workers may be unfamiliar with classroom learning, but they are very good with thought training. The capacity to absorb ideas by doing is better with old age rather than learning from a textbook or online training sessions. Therefore, you need to change the way you teach and train the older workforce rather than giving up on them or teaching them new skills. Moreover, in these high volatile times, old skills go obsolete too often and too frequently, that the updating and the upgrading of skills is a must for both old and younger workforce. Let's look at another myth. Older workers are in worth retraining because they won't be around too long. Today, younger workers move from job to job quickly because they haven't raised in an environment in which corporate loyalty is part of a thinking or tradition. On the other hand, older workers remain longer partly because they are more concerned about finding a new job if there is an economic slowdown. Another myth, older workers have poorer attendance records. Well, that's not true. According to a research by Beverly Goldberg, author of the book Age Works, human resource managers report that the older workers are less likely to be late or absent than younger workers. Here's a popular myth. Older workers are resistant to change. Totally false. Older workers know that they need to constantly upgrade themselves to stay relevant. If the right rationale is explained to them about any changes supported by skill building programs on the job, the older workers are quick to comply with changes. They may not be the early adopters to any technological changes, but you can't underestimate their ability to unlearn, learn, and relearn new things. There's an interesting anecdote about Jack Welch, the late CEO of GE. When Jack Welch was already a celebrated CEO back in the 90s, he made a surprising move that was so puzzling to his senior executives. He founded a 25-year-old computer whiz kid within the company to serve him as his technology mentor. He also insisted that the C-suite will follow suit, as GE was on the way to a widespread digitization at that time. Getting mentored by a young executive was unheard in the C-suite, but that bold move helped the top executives to understand the technology better. Usually in the mentoring field, it's always the old one mentoring the young ones, but in the world that is rapidly changing, mutual mentoring is a great option, where the young teaches the old one the new tricks and the old teaches the young ones the rules of the game. And here's the ultimate myth. Older workers have less to contribute. Here's the thing. Older workers have experience and expertise that has been accumulated over time. They possess deep insights that can guard a company's value and culture. They can also shorten the learning curve, better knowledge transition, institutional memory that can be applied in due diligence. The fact is that there is an aging population in the Western countries, and there's a rising of younger workforce in countries like India. What companies need to do is to strike a balance between younger workforce and the older ones. Complementing each other is the key here. One must not substitute the other. And just focusing only on one is highly detrimental to the company. Why not adapt your strategy to continuously train people on job? The world is changing rapidly. Gadgets are getting smarter. So why not people?